Hey, how's it going? Welcome back to Art. Just out taking our Magmasaur for a nice morning stroll in the park. Had to get some resources. So I've been doing a little bit of stuff at base, getting ready for today's video. We're gonna be doing some base building, and not just regular base building. We're gonna be doing some expanding on what we already have. So as you know, we are really, really running out of space. As you can see, we got a ton of metal. But we're running out of space, and we can't really go anywhere else because our little kind of like island that we're on right over there is totally filled with our normal base. So what we're going to be doing is using cliff platforms. Tell you what, little raptors all over the place. So instead of using regular cliff platforms, I was trying to see what we have with the S Plus pack, and it turns out that there are some glass ones. There's also some tech ones. We can't make the tech ones. So I went ahead and made up three of the glass ones. It's kind of why we're out of metal, man. Those things are extremely expensive. So the cement paste on those are like 1200 for each one, which isn't too bad because we have all of the chitin around, plus the beaver dams that are over there. And this dude is fantastic at harvesting stone as well. The thing that kind of use all of our stuff was all of our metal. So that's why I took him out. As you can see, we got plenty to throw into the forge. And I've already set out the platforms. Took me forever to get those things lined up. You know how I am. It takes me forever to get something lined up just perfect. So I figured I'd go ahead and set them out. And then today we can actually build on them. What I'm thinking is moving all three of the tech transmitters out onto those. Maybe kind of scatter them around, but let's get in here. And I'll kind of show you what we have set up. We'll leave him there for the moment. I kind of need to shuttle all of that metal inside. Yeah, see, we are so packed in here, man. We really don't have room for anything. Let's get on the Griffin. It's a little bit easier to show you that way. So these are the platforms. They're pretty big. They're about the same size as a stone one, I think. And I was kind of using the Griffin to be able to set him down just because he can do the front to back and side to side. The thing I was taking forever on is I was trying to line up for like the door. I was trying to have either one of the middle columns straight ahead or one of the big open spaces. And I can't really do it here. That's kind of the closest I can get to it. That way when our stairs come down, it kind of looks decent. Got the other one over here. We'll end up putting some railings around the outside, and then somewhere over here we'll make a little place for it to come down with some stairs. What's up, buddy? And same over here. We need to trim a couple of those trees out of the way, and then we'll go ahead and run some stairs, and we'll have three. So it'll look kind of cool because they're all kind of set out just the exact same. And I think with the tech transmitters on each one, it'll kind of look good, you know. So that being said, I think first thing we'll do is we need to grab some stairs. And I think I got some wooden ones already made up. Let's go ahead and pick these transmitters up too. Please do not demolish them. But what I'm thinking is maybe coming right down the middle. Right here. For the stairs, I want to do probably double wide. The thing is, I didn't look at that. It's not going to line up with one of those. It'll be fine. It doesn't have to line up exactly. Can I get on you so I can get back up, please? There we go. Let's grab some stairs. That way we don't have this problem. That's the first thing we'll start off. Then we'll move maybe the transmitters down. I was going to say, I know I have some stairs. Wrong one. Is that all that I have? Do I not have wooden ones? Oh wait, I got some on me, right there. Alright. We also need to get those trees out of the way before too long, too. So that'll be fine for there. It's not really in the middle, but I think it'll be alright. And then we can change the transparency. So here's the thing, too, is a little bit of the ground is poking through. I can't do too much about that. I tried raising it up, but it just doesn't work right. So instead of having this look like we're gonna fall through, we can change the transparency on it. See what one looks like. That's a little too solid. I want it to be somewhat see-through still. That's not too bad. What's 0.25 look like? That's still a little bit too much. 0.5 should be fine. You can still see down. It's got a nice little reflection. Doesn't look like you're going to fall off. And then we should be able to do railings. They do. They clip right to here. Oh, fantastic. That's the one thing about S Plus versus regular is regular ones, you got to put down the fence foundations. Clip them to that. Nothing ever lines up. So we are going to need a ton of railings around here. Let's go ahead and do the front and the side. The front one's going to be fairly simple. We're not putting much out here. I think what I'm going to do is this will be the one for our boss fights. I'll put the transmitter all the way out here at the end. It'll be kind of nice. It'll be right towards the front. And then it should be just a very small radius around here. We'll move the birds and stuff. I'm thinking over here we'll do maybe the rock drakes and stuff like that. And some of the birds. Maybe grab down, I don't know, kind of like the wyverns on the top. We'll grab some of the stuff down from up top. Put it down here, mainly the drakes. And then on this side we'll use for storage for like the, not the unicorns, but like the wolves. Stuff like that. So, change your transparency. Nice, nice. We might need to double these up. If we do, it's going to stick out through the bottom, isn't it? How's that going to look from the bottom? Oh, dude, I didn't think about that. That's okay. The foundation's kind of in the way, so you don't really see them. So that's not too bad. So we'll leave you here for right now. And I don't know what I'm going to do about right here, where it kind of goes up to land. I mean, we could have it to where we can just run across to here. I don't know why I would want to, but we'll leave it open, maybe. I haven't exactly thought this through too much. I pretty much got these made and got them set out and then went on that little metal run. That's kind of as far as I've gotten today. It's been quite a bit of work just getting that done. Let's grab some transmitters. I know we got the two from there. I want to get this last one up, too. Food and water. And I'm thinking about removing some of these doors. Just because, I mean, they're always open. They kind of get in the way sometimes. We don't really need them. I just like the actual doorways, you know? I'll tell you what, while we're here, let's make up some railings. Make sure we don't have any. Which we do. That'll be enough to do a couple. I'm thinking for the transmitter. I want it to come straight down off of the stairs. That's why I was wanting this to be lined up just right, so it doesn't look all weird. I mean, that might still look alright. So what is... Where's the range at? Oh, that's right, we can't see the range normally. What the way do we do a boss fight? I think it'll be fine, though. Like I said, nothing's going to be on the front of the building. And that should be far enough back. Let's double check, make sure how the spacing is on that versus the door. I think it's fine. I think it's going to be fine. We'll leave it like that or else we'll be here forever. Dude, it took me so long just to get these things placed down, man. Let's get a couple of these out. Just so nobody goes running off the edge. Just saying, it does happen quite often. And I like how they clip just perfectly. I think we had 31. 31 in our inventory? Kind of want to see how many we have. See if we need to make up some more for the other side. Yeah, see, it looks a little weird how it just stops right there. Can I do railings going? I can't. They just clip on the outside. We could put some fence foundations down to kind of wall this off. Kind of the same thing right there? I don't know. I think it'll be fine. We might need to go ahead and put some walls up, though, just to cover these up. I don't know. Let's hop on the bird, see how it looks. Is this even on? It's not. Sure, it'll look a little bit better at night when it lights up some. That's not too bad, though. We need to get some of our flags. Get some more of the Viking flags. Maybe we'll do that, too. I like the ones right up here by the door. Maybe we'll make two more and set them kind of in the corners down here. Just so that it's not all kind of plain looking, you know? Take a look at that real quick. I think those are fairly cheap to make. Fantastic. Two of those. That'll be a little something here for where the railing stops too, you know? There we go. Do the same thing here. Nice, nice. I really, really like those flags. I wish they had a bigger and smaller version of them. I think they look pretty cool. And I'm thinking about putting some torches out here. We kind of need to do that here soon, too. Some regular ones on the outside. Just because it kind of, I don't know, I think it'll look good with the nighttime, you know? So I guess we should go ahead and just put all of the transmitters the same. Let's see, let's run down right here. Hopefully it doesn't look weird with that being off-center. That's the one thing I'm kind of worried about. And I was thinking about moving the greenhouse, but dude, that is so much to move. Why have I got four more again? I've gotten rid of that one I don't know how many times. I don't know if something's glitched and they just keep reproducing. I've got them all turned off of mating. One, two, three. All right, well, let's see. We'll see how that works out here in a few minutes. But yeah, I was thinking about moving the greenhouse out to one just because there's so much space. But dude, then we have to repipe everything in again. It's going to be off-centered a little bit too. I mean, it'll be fine. Oh, I don't have any stairs. Two should be enough. I'm hoping. It's kind of down a little bit low. Nah, we're good. Just high enough. And see, this one kind of came out perfect with it being lined up. Nice, nice. Cool. Let's go ahead and grab the rest of our railings real quick. We got eight left. We might have enough. I don't think so, but we can always make a couple more. It's not that big of a deal. And we only want the S Plus ones. We don't want the regular ones. A little bit of water while we're right there. Might as well. I don't like the grass sticking through, but I mean, not much else I can do. It's got a really weird clip point, and it was not wanting me to raise it up any higher. I'm hoping one will be, well, I mean, yeah, we shouldn't need to go too high. I was also thinking about putting some metal ones out here, but we don't really have anything metal at our base, right? It's kind of why I was thinking about doing stone platforms, but I think they're a little bit smaller than these are. Okay, we'll leave that right there. I really don't know how to cap these off without it looking weird. Excuse me, pardon me. I did not realize this island was going to be so cluttered whenever we did it, or else we would have built on the bigger one. I thought about moving our stuff a couple times, but dude, that is a lot to rebuild over there, you know? Dude, I almost ran off the edge. I thought it was a little bit closer. I did need some wood back for the cabinet, so that kind of works out. I was thinking about moving over here, too, where the Giga is in the corner. Moving our breeding area over. That way, when we use the mutator, we don't actually have to move everybody, right? They can kind of just stay where they are because that little corner is kind of over out of the way. So I'll probably take up the mutator. We'll put it over there and do some testing to see how far the range is. And that'll be something to move that'll be very, very simple. Let's get some railings up before somebody runs off the edge like what almost happened right there. Kind of wish we still had the tree over here, but I mean, it'll be fine. Cool, so we need quite a few more of those. Let's move this mutator real quick to test and see how the range is. Empty. Fantastic. And I think the transmutator is the same range, so I think if we put those all the way over here in the corner, it'd be kind of the best bet. Maybe like this one here and one there. I think that'll kind of work. Put maybe like a torch behind it. Oh, that is, yeah, that's perfect, man. We can increase it a little bit if we need to. But I mean, nothing that we're going to do should be too much out of this range, right? I kind of like how most of it goes off the side there. So cool, that's what we'll do. Let's go ahead and grab the other one. And then all I got to worry about is making sure that those two things have power. Oh wait, we got the tech generator, so it should. Where's the pickup? There we go. Just double check, make sure it is empty. Where is, there we go. I wish all of these were in the same location, you know? Just saying, it'd make life a lot easier. Cool. Let's move you out of the way. I did get rid of the other Giga. Just because, dude, we are so shy on space. But, I mean, this will give us room to keep, like, the drakes and stuff out. I will put you right next to it. And then I think we'll do this right here. That's going to be backwards, isn't it? There we go. Oh, you know what? Maybe we should go ahead and raise up the railings around this too. Since I'm making some more railings. Since we have the issue of everybody wanting to jump off the side. And we'll put her, I guess like right here will be fine. What is your range? Oh, that's plenty. That should be fine. There we go. Cool. Let me get some more railings made up. I need to make quite a few to finish that. And this, we'll hop on the Griffin. Where is the Griffin? He's over here. Let's take a look and see what it looks like real quick before we go too much further. Looks kind of weird with the trees gone, man. I was really, really hoping to keep some of the trees around. It's not too bad. I think it'll look fine. We need to test to make sure that it actually works still. The transmitters, they should. But you never know, man. Stuff changes so much. Let's do Angler. Okay, there's all of our coordinates. So I was told if we put out more of these that it'll eventually show the levels. I mean, the levels aren't too big of a deal. Not too worried about it. So I don't know. Maybe we'll get some more and maybe put them on top. But like I said, that's all the way back over on Genesis. I do have one more. So we have four here. I don't think putting one more out is going to matter too much. We can definitely throw it out real quick and see. It doesn't. It shows all the same stuff, so we can't really see levels still. Yep, so one more. Wait. Wait, it does. So I wonder what it's. So how come some things it shows a level, but not others? Is that because they're very close to us? Maybe the more you have, the further the range? Good possibility. So all this stuff is really far away. Interesting. Pick that one up. Maybe. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe we'll put the other ones up on top. Or something. We'll figure that out later. I don't want to put too many of them out here. It's going to look kind of weird having transmitters scattered all over the place. We really don't have room in here. I was thinking about, maybe we could put them in here. Put two of them in here. That's kind of clipping through. I don't know. That's kind of big to be inside here. We do have all the flags and stuff to go in here anyways. I don't know. I'll figure it out later. Let me get these railings made and we'll get those set out and at least get that part finished. I totally didn't notice that Giga almost broke all of our armor. Except for the pants. Dude, the durability on those pants are fantastic. Alright, so we have the rest of our railings, which should be fine. I also want to play with today. There's a storage unit for the soul traps. So I want to take a look at that, get one of those, get it set out, and see what it's all about. Because I would like to start storing a lot of our teams instead of keeping them out. And I think while they're in the soul traps, they still get XP and stuff like that. So it's not that big of a deal to have them kind of put away. Let's move you over, somebody, just for a few minutes. We'll figure out where to put you here soon. Hey, what, we're going through water like crazy. Oh yeah, let's throw the rest of the railings over here. Dude, it looks so bare over here now with those trees gone. I don't know. It's kind of weird. So maybe, I think three high should be fine. I don't think the Drakes or the Gigas will be able to four-wheel drive over that. I hope not, at least. I know metal ones would look a ton better, but we're not exactly doing metal too much in this playthrough. So what do we got? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Want to make sure they're somewhat the same. Alright. That looks not too bad. I think it'll be fine. Like I said, we'll put some torches right behind it. And that way it'll look a little bit better at nighttime. I wish this had an activate like that does. How it has a... That kind of lights up. Which is kind of opened up like the other ones. Anyways, let's see about making this other soul trap thing real quick. I think this is it right here. Soul terminal. Where is it made at? In our inventory? It is. Not exactly sure where we're going to put it at. How big is it? Oh, it's tiny. We'll probably put it right in here. We should move this over. Actually, we don't even need that anymore. Just using it for looks. That's alright, we'll still keep it out. Looks kind of neat. Alright, so what is this thing? That is a very bad button to have here. Is there a confirmation? Okay, there is a confirmation. Thank goodness, because if I have everything in here, the way I click on stuff, oh dude. And then, what is this for? Soul recovery. I think that's just to back up your teams, possibly? So, inventory options are only available if tribute terminal is toggled off in the radial wheel. No fuel cost. So, what is... Holy crap, dude, there's a lot of stuff in here. Options. Normal, modern mesh. Private soul transfers. Collisions are on, text, newborn auto traps. I'm guessing if something is hatched, it'll automatically throw it into a soul trap. That's kind of neat. An automation. Is there a range? What's under admin? Bug zapper, auto trap. Range is only 15. How big is 15? Is there a range? I don't see a range on it. Fifteen doesn't seem that far. I don't know. I don't see any range markers. That's another thing I'm going to have to definitely read up on to see exactly what all it does. Let's turn that back off just for the moment. Maybe because it wasn't enabled? And then autumn, is this... I don't understand the mating either. Abort gestation? Still don't see nothing. Interesting. So we'll leave that off for the moment. I just don't want to mess with it. But we'll go ahead and put our stuff in there. We have quite a few things over here. Here's all of our wolves for our boss fights. And I have our aloes. Okay, okay, okay. And then these are our rock drakes that I was using for breeding. So it doesn't really do anything to them while they're in here. I don't know. It's weird. That's the list of them all. Okay. Like I said, I'll look at it later, but it's definitely something for an easy way for keeping them. And there's not a timer or nothing, right? Yeah, no fuel cost. Okay. And we can hold 300 in here. Well, it's definitely an easy way to keep everything kind of sorted out. So, speaking of sorting things out. Oh, that's right. You're stuck in the ground. We got to pick you up and move you like this. Oh, dude. Yep, yep, yep. That's quite the quite the drop there. So with that gone, we might actually be able to keep the Gigas over here. So we're only going to have the two. So what I'm thinking about with the Gigas is in the snow biome, there is that mini boss, and then there's also the Ice Titan. So I'm thinking about breeding a little Giga army to take on the Ice Titan. I have never taken that on without using a mech. Can I please get you sorted out straight here? But I've never taken him on without using one of the mechs, and we don't have a mech here. So we could build one, but I'd prefer to do it with dinos instead. Dude, please don't knock down our last tree. So that's kind of the goal of the first thing we'll do with the Gigas is take on the Ice Titan. All right, so that's kind of sorted out. Let's get some of these guys over here out onto the platform. I think everything that I want to breed, I want to keep out over here. Little stuff, that is, you know? Oh, I should put some more. Hey, well, let's just go ahead and do this. We need the wooden ones. And then do we have any? We got a couple of those left. We'll just kind of block this off right here. I don't want it looking all weird. We should be able to attach these. We can. Fantastic. So that kind of blocks it off at least. So this will kind of be our breeding side. Safe and away from everybody. And I think once we get a couple more of the unicorns, it'll be fine to leave these guys out here. I don't think anything is going to come around. We don't have anything aggressive yet that comes around here. And the only thing, well, ah, man, you know what? These should be on the other side because we have the nanny right over there. And then this side should be for the flyers, the drakes, the birds, all that stuff. All right, tell you what, let me start moving these guys around and we'll do that. That way it's real easy to give birth and then we can probably move the nanny just onto that platform or over close to it. Yeah, I'm thinking for her, maybe we should move her all the way over there in the corner and then turn her range on. She can do the whole thing. Let's test that out real quick. It's a lot of moving around today. So if we put her over here, which we'll put her in the corner, but so that almost reaches the whole thing. So if we put her in the corner, that'll cover this whole area and maybe even go far enough over that way. And we can't increase her range, can we? We can't. But that'll be fine. That'll be not too bad. And that'll be a whole little breeding area. And we can upload stuff there to go to other maps. So that will be fantastic. Let me get these guys all moved over. Alright, so we just about got this sorted out. And I tell you what, man. The structural integrity of this glass. It's definitely being tested. Ah, putting two gigas out here. might not have been the smartest thing, and dude, it took me forever to get them around here without tearing down my last tree over there. But I think it's gonna work out pretty good. I've got just about everybody over here. So these are all of our normal teams that we use every day. Well, usually every day. Our medic, I'm not sure. I kind of want to set up a medic station, and I don't know what to do with this guy yet. He's definitely gonna be left out. I'm thinking about maybe putting him over here on the side. Once we get them bred, I'll keep our normal one over there, because I do use him quite a bit for stone and everything else. As for this whole area, I kind of want to leave it open for breeding, and maybe, I don't know, maybe the Magmasaurs we can put over here, just because they're so big. So this is a perfect spot for her. She literally covers the whole range of the platform, so everything is in, it's in range for her, right? So whenever we're doing mating, we don't have to move anybody. They can just hatch and be fine where they're at. I'm going to move the egg incubator. Well, let's do it now. I'm going to move it too. I want that to be in range of her. And I want to leave these over here. I want those out of the way so we don't have to worry about moving stuff every time that we want to change something. Which, I mean, it isn't very often. But when we do, it's kind of nice to have everything over out of the way. I think for the eggs, we will put it right here. Maybe right there. Ah, I hate how it always comes up backwards. It's only the S plus one that does that. And then we'll go ahead and put the rest of our railings kind of right here. We don't have to really worry about too much about them falling off too, is one reason why I like it being over there. Versus over here, if for some reason they will four-wheel drive up and over, it's, I mean, it's quite the fall down there. And there's usually raptors down there too. Grab these, we'll move them over. It is daytime already. If I can actually pick up the correct things. Cool. So yeah, that gives us a ton of room. I do want to do our little take parasaur kind of farm going on too. I don't know if that's going to work, but that might be a way for us to get a bunch of element dust that we can turn into element shards and then into sheets easier than trying to do the boss fights all the time. See, let's get a couple more of these up and we should be good. Nice, and that's our little hatching area done. Kind of out of the way from everything too. And I think this is enough range. Oh, dude, we are getting so low on food. But this should be ranged to reach all the way off the side. We gotta go over there anyways. We'll take this dude. And I want to get our rock drakes out. They're all kind of put away at the moment. Yeah, it does. Cool. It goes the whole range of it. So, let's leave you here. And back you up a little bit. Just so you're not in the way. And I want to grab our rock drake down from up there. Put him over here. And then grab our two that we use for breeding. I'm going to leave these guys. These are all the ones that we use for. Wait a minute. Where's our... Huh. I did have some of the... What are they called? These right here. Like the hitch post setup. Wonder where they went to. I didn't pick them up. But I can get in front of all these guys now for picking up eggs. Don't have to worry about their tails being all in the way. Dude, I tell you what, I have gone through food like crazy today. So we'll grab those. And these. Those all go out to the mating area. And this dude, if we can work it out, he'll go down here. I'm not sure. I might have to move something out. Maybe I'll move the Maywing. He's a little bit smaller. He can fit by the Gigas a little bit easier. I know, the Gigas won't be here forever, just until we get a couple good eggs, and then we can kind of put them away. They're kind of a little bit too big to be up here, really. And I ran out of wood. I was going to make some more of the fence foundation so we can kind of sort that out, the edges, but I'm out of wood, and I don't feel like farming any right now. I'll fix that off camera when we're done recording. All right, let's turn off the range for the feeding trough and get these last couple guys out before we go. Dude, it looks so bare over here without all the all the dinos. It is so nice, though, to have a little bit extra room, though. Seeing how cramped up we've been lately? Oh, I don't have saddles. We gotta make a saddle real quick for them so I can move them around. Totally forgot about that whenever we came back in the last video with them. Alright, so we got two of those making up. While that's doing that, let's throw out our drakes. Turn the lights down a little bit. It is getting morning time. Do I not have saddles for you guys either? Well, I'll tell you what. Okay, I got a saddle on this one. Put these in the corner if I can get around the aloes. There we go. Alright, let me borrow your saddle, buddy. I need to make some more. I think that takes the fungal wood, which is why I haven't made any more. I still need to go back down in the aberration area. Try to get us an otter, which, since we have the tech transmitter, it says there's a ton of otters around. I don't know why we haven't seen any, but we definitely need to get another one. Alright, so there's those guys sorted out. Excuse me, sir. Or ma'am, whichever you are. Ma'am, sorry about that. It happens, man, it happens. Yeah, I think I'm gonna leave the dragons up there. I do like the way they look. Alright, where is our saddles? It's one for you. And one for you. Wait. There we go. These things are so loud. I'll go stomping around, man. Tear up my glass. Oh, yeah. And let's do this before something bad happens. Boy, I totally forgot about putting everybody on passive. All right. Oh, dude. Yep. A little too close to the edge. Oh, please don't fall. Oh, man, I tell you what. Close. You were trying. You were trying. Cool. Well, we still got room there. Could probably make some more room here if we needed to. But then you got all this room in here, too. So there's plenty of space for more breeding. Plenty of room over here. Let's go ahead and grab our Magmasaur. Get him out of the doorway. Dude is, like, guarding it, man. Thing that sucks is I have a ton of metal I need to take inside. I'll probably just load it into the Argentavis since he fits. Dude, this guy's tail is so big. I might need to move my feeding trough. I mean, it might be alright. Should be fine. And I think that's just about it for today. It's been a oh, wait. Wait. Let's grab these guys. Actually, let's leave these two birds up here. Just because. I kind of like keeping them out of the way. That was kind of the main point, was making one for birds. But, I mean, it's fine. It's fine. Do a quick flyby. I think it turned out pretty well. Not too bad of a day. We do have more room. That kind of sorted out our teams a little bit. And I didn't notice whenever I put down the platforms, it usually tells you that you can only have three in the area. I didn't get that with these. So we might be able to put some more down below if we run out of space or for some reason decide to do a lot of breeding with mutations. It all depends on how long we're on this map, because Lost Island is coming out in a couple of weeks and we will be going there. Hopefully we'll be done here by the time that comes out. But not too bad, man. We are going to go ahead and leave this one here. Hope you enjoyed the video. Hope you like our little base build. A little bit of expansion and messing around today. As always, thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.